So today's topic is diphtheria. Diphtheria is an acute upper respiratory tract infectious disease caused by Corynebacterium diphtheri. It is a facultative anaerobic gram-positive bacteria. A facultative anaerobe is an organism that makes ATP by aerobic respiration if oxygen is present, but is capable of switching to fermentation of anaerobic respiration if oxygen is absent. The anobligate aerobes, by contrast, cannot make ATP in absence of oxygen, and obligate anaerobes dies in presence of oxygen. The disease is characterized by sore throat, low fever, and liberation of an exotoxin resulting in an adherent membrane on tonsil, pharynx, and nasal cavity. This picture shows the pseudomembrane, white color membrane over the pharyngeal area and tonsils. Diphtheria is also characterized by congestion, edema or local tissue destruction, regional, that is submandibular lymphadenopathy that looks like bull neck appearance, and toxemia. Picture shows a child with bull neck diphtheria. Now regarding problem statement, up to latest data, diphtheria is a rare disease in most developed countries owing to routine children vaccination. During the year 2016, about 7,097 diphtheria cases were reported globally. In India, diphtheria is an endemic disease, and during year 2017, 5,293 cases and 148 deaths were reported, showing a case fatality rate of about 2.79. Now, what are different major types? According to the site of involved site, anterior nasal, pharyngotonsillar, and laryngotracheal. Other types are conjunctival, skin, and genital diphtheria. This picture shows eye with inflammatory conjunctivitis. Conjunctiva show congestion in the lower palpebral conjunctiva. Easily peelable membrane is seen, which is due to inflammation. Diphtheria of skin of neck. Now comes to the epidemiology. Now agent factor. Agent is Corynebacterium diphtheri. It is gram-positive, non-acid fast, non-motile bacteria. About types, it is gravis, mites, intermedius, or belfenti. Gravis infections tend to be more severe than mites infection. Toxin production occurs only when the bacillus is itself infected by a specific virus, that is bacteriophages or lysogenic beta phages, carrying the genetic information for toxin. It is also known as toxin gene. Now, cases and carriers are source of infection, and about up to 95 carriers for 5 cases. Carrier may be temporary or chronic. It may be nasal or throat. And incidence of carrier in a community may vary from 0.1 to 5%. Nasal carriers are more dangerous because of frequent shedding of infective material, and temporary carrier stage may last for about 1 month, but chronic carrier stage may persist for a year or so unless the patient is treated. Now, infective material is nasopharyngeal secretion or discharge from skin lesions, or maybe fomites. What are fomites? Fomites are inanimate articles or substances other than water and food contaminated by infectious discharges from the patient and capable of harboring and transferring the infectious agent to the healthy individual. Fomites may be throat spatula, utensil, toys, or pencils. Now, period of infectivity, it may ranges from 2 to 4 weeks or unless treated. Carrier may remain infective for much longer period. Now, host factor. Commonly 1 to 5 years of children are involved, एंड द इक्वल इंसिडेंस इज फाउंड इन मेल एंड फीमेल्स. नाउ एनवायरमेंटल फैक्टर, केसेस अकर्स इन ऑल सीजन ऑल्दो विंटर फेवर्स इट्स स्प्रेड. पोर्टल ऑफ एंट्री, कॉमन रूट इज रेस्पिरेटरी बट समटाइम्स पोर्टल ऑफ एंट्री मे बी द स्किन वेयर कट्स वोंड्स एंड अल्सर नॉट प्रॉपरली अटेंडेड और मे गेट इन्फेक्टेड विद डिप्थीरिया बैसिलाई. मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन, एज नेसोफेरिंजियल सीक्रेशन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ड्रॉपलेट इन्फेक्शन और ड्रॉपलेट न्यूक्लियर इन्फेक्टेड क्यूटेनियस लेजन और थ्रू मिल्क फूड एंड फोमाइट्स. नाउ पैथोजेनेसिस, द ऑर्गेनिज्म यूजुअली इन्फेक्ट्स द एपिथीलियम ऑफ स्किन एंड म्यूकोजा ऑफ अपर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक लीडिंग टू इन्फ्लेमेशन. नोज एंड लैरिक्स आर कॉमन फॉर इन्फेक्शंस. डिप्थीरिया बैसिलाई कोलोनाइज एंड ग्रो ऑन म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन एंड स्टार्ट टू प्रोड्यूस टॉक्सिन विच इज देन एब्जॉर्ब इन टू द म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन्स एंड इवन स्प्रेड बाई ब्लड स्ट्रीम. लोकल टॉक्सिक जेनिक इफेक्ट्स एलिसिट इन्फ्लेमेटरी रेस्पॉन्स एंड नेक्रोसिस ऑफ द फेशियल म्यूकोसा सेल्स, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ दैट लीड्स टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्यूडो मेम्ब्रेन एंड स्यूडो मेम्ब्रेन इज कम्पोज ऑफ बैक्टीरिया, लिम्फोसाइट्स, प्लाज्मा सेल, फेब्रिन एंड डेड सेल दैट कॉजिंग रेस्पिरेटरी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन. सिस्टमिक टॉक्सिकजेनिक इफेक्ट causes necrosis in heart muscle, liver, kidney or and adrenal also produces the neural damage. Incubation period is 2 to 6 days. What is incubation period? It is a time gap between infection to illness. Now comes to the clinical feature. Symptoms are due to infection are nausea and vomiting, chills, headache and fever, and symptoms due to pseudomembrane formation are sore throat, difficulty in swallowing and difficulty in breathing. The disease can involve almost any mucous membrane. For clinical purposes, it is convenient to classify diphtheria into 4 categories depending on the site of disease or depending on the pseudomembrane. It may be nasal, pharyngeotonsillar, laryngotracheal, cutaneous and other side infection. Now comes to the anterior nasal, more common in infants. Rhinorrhea, that means discharge from nose, the discharge may be watery, serosanguinous, purulent or foul smelling. Serosanguinous means containing both blood and the liquid part of blood, that is serum. For example, fluid exiting a wound that is serosanguinous is yellowish with a small amount of blood, and purulent is white and thick secretions. A white pseudomembrane usually forms on the nasal septum and delayed systematic manifestations are there. Now pharyngeal or tonsillar, symptoms sore throat, 50% have fever and few have dysphagia, hoarseness, malaise or headache. What are different signs? Unilateral or bilateral tonsillar membrane formation which extend to cover uvula, soft palate, posterior oropharynx, hypopharynx and glottis. Signs also involve soft tissue edema, enlarged lymph nodes resulting in bull neck appearance, especially submandibular lymph node. Efforts to remove membrane result in hemorrhages. Now laryngeal diphtheria. Laryngeal diphtheria can be either an extension of the pharyngeal form, that is very common, or the only laryngeal site is involved, that is rarely seen. Noisy breathing, stridor, hoarseness of voice, dry cough, fever, these are the common symptoms. It also may lead to asphyxia. The pseudomembrane can lead to airway obstruction, coma and death. Now cutaneous diphtheria, skin infection are quite common in tropics. Skin infection may be manifested by a scaling, rash or by ulcer with clearly demarcated edges and pseudomembranes, that is also known as punched out ulcer. It is punched out ulcer, it is often appears as a secondary infection over the previous skin abrasion or infection. कंजंक्टाइवल डिप्थीरिया इट अफेक्ट्स पैल्पेब्रल कंजंक्टाइवा. प्रेजेंटेशन इज इडिमेटस इडिमेटस एंड मेम्ब्रेन फॉर्मेशन. ऑरल डिप्थीरिया इट इन्वॉल्व ओटाइटिस. इट बेसिकली प्रेजेंट एज ओटाइटिस एक्सटर्ना. डिस्चार्ज में भी परसिस्टेंट पुरुलेंट और फॉल स्मेलिंग. नाउ कम्स टू द डायग्नोसिस. स्पेसिमेन शुड बी टेकन नेजल एंड थ्रोट स्वैब और एनी अदर म्यूकोक्यूटेनियस लेजन में भी टेकन. पोर्शन ऑफ मेम्ब्रेन एंड अंडरलाइन एक्सुडेट इज ऑल्सो सबमिटेड. The current definition of diphtheria used by the Center of Disease Control and Prevention is based both on laboratory and clinical criteria. So what are laboratory criteria? Isolation of Corynebacterium diphtheria from the throat or nasal culture from a clinical specimen. And clinical criteria is upper respiratory tract illness with sore throat, low grade fever, dyspnea, noisy breathing and adherent pseudomembrane of the tonsil, pharynx and or nose. Now comes to the treatment. Start treatment at earliest on clinical suspicion and don't wait for laboratory reports. Now what are different treatment principles? Antitoxins, antibiotic, supportive treatment and manage complication. Antitoxin, it neutralizes circulating toxin. Antibiotic that eradicate bacteria. Now, first of all, for antitoxin that neutralizes circulating toxins. The passive immunization or immunoglobulin is also given. ADS anti-diphtheria serum for of horse origin and human origin, both are available. Now, horse origin, it should be given without delay. IM, horse origin means any horse origin or human origin antitoxic treatment should be given without delay. IM or IV in doses ranging from 20,000 to 1 lakh unit. It is for horse origin antisera or more depending upon the severity of cases. As in mild, early pharyngeal and laryngeal disease, the dose of horse origin antidiphtherium serum is 20,000 to 40,000 units. Moderate nasopharyngeal disease के लिए 40,000 to 60,000 units. And for severe extensive, that is swelling in neck or late disease manifesting more than 3 days or more disease, severe disease के लिए 80,000 to 1 lakh international unit. A preliminary test of 2 ml subcutaneously should be done to detect sensitization to horse serum. Now, for human origin, dose is 0.6 ml per kg body weight intramuscular, available as 2 ml vial with 300 mg globulin. And advantage over horse origin antidiphtheria serum, it is hypersensitivity is absent and it provide longer protection. Now comes to the antibiotic. Antibiotic is no substitute to antitoxin at the disease manifestation is because of liberation of toxins. Stop production of more toxins. ठीक है, by the killing of bacteria. Every case should be treated with penicillin or erythromycin for 5 to 6 days to clear the throat of Corynebacterium diphtheriae and thereby decreases toxin production. Now for contacts and carrier, risk of developing diphtheria after exposure to case is about 2% and to carrier is approximately 0.3%. Detection of carrier should be done by nasal and throat swab examination. Now management of contact and carriers, the carrier should be treated with 10 days course of oral erythromycin, which is the most effective drug for treatment of carriers. Treatment should be given to all contacts regardless of immunization status. For non-immunized close contact, 1000 to 2000 unit of diphtheria antitoxin should be given and actively immunized against active immunization against diphtheria should be also be done. Now immunized contact, if they are already immunized, then explore the history. If booster dose or primary immunization is given within past 2 years, then no action is required. But if booster dose or primary immunization is given more than 2 years, then booster dose of diphtheria toxoid should be given. Now, supportive therapy, first of all, isolation, that may be in hospital, bed rest for 2 weeks, monitor respiratory cardiac function, wash cutaneous lesions, check gag reflex. It is also known as laryngeal spasm. That is a reflex contraction of back of the throat evoked by touching the roof of mouth or back of tongue. Sedative, hypnotics are contraindicated. High calorie soft diet should be given. Suction of secretion, if any, and avoid exertion. Case fatality rate in case of diphtheria with treatment is less than 5% and without treatment is around 10%. Now, prognosis is associated with virulence of organism. Maybe it gravis, as earlier told, gravis strain is poor prognosis. Age, immunization status, site of infection, speed of administration of toxin, myocarditis, poor respiratory monitoring, and pharyngeal nerve paralysis is associated with poor prognosis. Now, diphtheria complication, asphyxia, myocarditis, neurological involvement, that may be palatal or pharyngeal paralysis, cranial neuropathies, polyneuropathies. Asphyxia, obstruction of respiratory passage by membrane that leads to tachypnea, stridor, use of accessory muscle of respiration, and cyanosis. Treatment of asphyxia is tracheostomy or humidifier air should be given. Myocarditis, it occurs in acute phase. Toxic cardiomyopathy occurs in approximately 10 to 25% patient and is responsible for 50 to 60% of death. It occurs usually in second and or third week of illness. Treatment of myocarditis, bed rest, avoid exertion, restricted fluid and salt intake, diuretics, may need sedation and oxygen and digoxin in cases of decompensated heart. Neurological involvement, the onset of primary infection. It is multiphasic in onset. Up to 2 to 3 weeks, palatal and pharyngeal paralysis is noted, and up to fifth week, cranial neuropathies may occur. 10 days to 3 months, polyneuropathies may occur. Palatal and pharyngeal paralysis in neurological involvement that leads to swallowing difficulty, nasal voice, regurgitation through nose. Peripheral neuropathy occurs in 1 to 3 months after the infection, and paresthesia resolves completely. Paresthesia is abnormal skin sensation like tingling, prickling, chilling, burning, or numb sensations. What are different treatment? Nasogastric feeding and treatment of general weakness. Now comes to the surveillance. Medical surveillance of all contacts for 1 week after exposure should be done. Bacteriological surveillance should be done weekly for several weeks. Now, immunization. Immunization does not prevent the occurrence of carrier stage. Immunization vaccine, it is available in combined or mixed vaccine form, such as pentavalent vaccine, diphtheria pertussis tetanus toxoid vaccine, diphtheria tetanus toxoid vaccine, diphtheria tetanus of adult type of vaccines. Single vaccine may be available as formal toxoid, alum precipitated toxoid, purified toxoid aluminium phosphate, purified toxoid aluminium hydroxide, toxoid antitoxin flocules, and antisera, that is also already told, diphtheria antitoxins. Now, DPT vaccine, now it is in the form of pentavalent vaccine. In DPT vaccine, there are three contents: diphtheria toxoid, pertussis, and tetanus toxoid. In pentavalent, in hepatitis B and hemophilus influenza, protection is also provided in that combined vaccine. DPT mean dose is 0.5 ml, pentavalent is also dose is 0.5 ml, route is deep intramuscular, and recommended site is anterior lateral part of thigh. First dose DPT or pentavalent vaccine, either may be first dose at 6 week, second then 10 week, then third is 14 week, then DPT first booster is 18 to 24 month and second booster at 4 to 5 years. What are different side effects? Local swelling, tenderness, slight fever, excessive somnolence, protected inconsolable crying, neurological reaction, convulsion, and encephalopathy may occur very rarely. What are different contraindications? Acute febrile illness, evolving or suspected neurological illness, and severe reaction to the prior dose of DPT. DT adult type, it contains diphtheria toxoid and tetanus toxoid. Indication, no immunized children more than 7 of years of age. Doses, two doses at the interval of 4 to 8 weeks, booster first after 6 to 12 months and second after 10 years. Thank you.